Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus. What a great day to be alive. Wonderful day. We welcome you to Choices. Hello to your friends. Pull the family close together and let them know that Choices is back again. We want you to stay tuned with us as we continue our discussion on the dark side. Now we are sure that you are now knowledgeable how to deal with and to overcome that dark side. Stay with us, gentlemen.
In addition to the blood of Jesus, the word of God, faith in the Holy Ghost, this evening we want to continue to look at the dark side by examining the significance of knowledge. You know, my school teacher, a woman by the name of Crawford, Mrs. Crawford, we refer to her as Mother Prof, used to have us repeat the answers to some questions that she would ask. And one of the questions that she asked is, what is knowledge? And we had to say, knowledge is power. Everybody in the class. Then she would say, what is ignorance? And we would have to repeat, the most disgraceful thing on the face of the earth. It follows that no human being should declare, you know, I'm big and ignorant, and feel proud about that. Hosea 4:6 talks about the lack of knowledge, how people can be destroyed. And this knowledge that we're speaking about, it's not only knowledge that we would have attained from the university, but we're talking about the Word of God, because the Word of God is all-encompassing anyhow. So when we have this kind of knowledge that we're talking about, we will see change in behavior. Christians go through transformation because their minds would have been transformed because of what the Word of God, you know, is capable of doing. So we see modification of behaviors. We see the individual being able to think and to reason, not to kill and to chop every time somebody says something that might not be pleasing to you. You want to fight and roll in the ground and so on. And you also develop values, core values, good values such as honesty, cooperation, patience, tolerance, you know. And so even as you're exposed to knowledge, we can actually see the dark side being dealt with. And so we want to look at the significance of knowledge in addition to the foundation that we've already said. That is the blood of Jesus, the word of God, and faith in the Holy Ghost. Gentlemen.
You know, the young man who made this statement about adding to your faith, knowledge, is a young man who at one time was classified as being wild and ruthless. Peter is the one who made this observation. And Peter, in his growth, will recognize the power and the value of not just being gifted and being skilled, of not just having faith, believing in God, but that along with your giftedness, along with your faith, there are things that we must deliberately, consistently go after. And hence, he now says, add to your faith, not just goodness, but to your faith, add knowledge. Solomon said, wisdom is the principal thing. And in all of your getting, get understanding. I don't know if you've ever had the opportunity, but attempting to logically, reasonably resolve an issue with someone, and they are severely depleted in the area of either biblical knowledge or secular knowledge. Ability to reason, a reasonable conclusion is extremely difficult. I had that twice. It is the most frustrating thing to ever have. And so I have found that if there isn't knowledge of the Word of God and a secular understanding, that sometimes we are so deprived that we give way to the dark side more easily. We allow, so we say, I could kill you, I could chop you up, I'm gonna poison you tonight. Now, I pray that through this program, you and I will recognize the value and add to our faith knowledge.
Peter was a person who was very violent and denied Christ 3 times, but yet still he gained knowledge and used it to tell others that you must build up your faith. Mm-hmm. You see, knowledge is power, mm-hmm. and Peter gained power right there.
You know,
helping others to gain also.
Peter also destroyed the myth that somebody mentioned, I don't know how long ago, what you don't know can hurt you. That is, as serious as it is, destructive. Without knowledge, you can be destroyed. Because if you don't know how to operate, what is expected of you, in whatever situation you find yourself in, you can do some foolish things. You can say some foolish things. And that is simply because you don't know how to operate in that particular issue. So knowledge of who you are can come to you if you know that God has a plan and purpose for your life.
Well, one of the benefits of having knowledge is that it informs your behavior. You know, I was in the community of South Tryville quite recently, and I saw an elderly gentleman. He was sitting on a stool painting his gate. And I admired this gentleman. I said to myself, look at life. And I asked myself this question, what would hinder me from being able to reach this age that this gentleman has attained, you know? And I thought of the practices in life. And I thought also of the many young persons that had already exited this life. And as I was thinking about that, I even was thinking about my own self and maybe the things that I as an individual struggle with, you know? And I said to myself, the power of knowledge is so important. Because if I don't have knowledge of myself and my shortcomings, you know, I'll continue along a destructive path. The other thing is that once I'm aware of those things that are out there that can hinder me from fulfilling purpose, well, then I'm in a better position to bring correction along with the help of the Holy Spirit, the Word of God, and the power of the Lord Jesus Christ working in and through me to better be able to live a life that will bring honor and glory to Him, and also a life that will be an example to others that they can see the working and the transforming power of the Lord Jesus
Christ. You know, you touched on something very important there in terms of how the person would conduct themselves or his or herself with knowledge, and that's the whole thing about the individual being able to fulfill their potential. Every human being has the capacity to perform and to develop and to grow. Mm-hmm. But if you don't have this knowledge of who you are, what you're capable of, you end up in the cemetery without doing the things that God has really designed you to do. And that's why it's important that, you know, people spend time studying and going to school. And when I say school, I don't necessarily mean that, you know, bishops and QC and so on, but a man, you know, you could school yourself even as an adult. You might not have had these kinds of opportunities, but it is never too late to school yourself to learn, so you could, you know, really temper your behavior and fulfill potential.
You know, even in the environment that we live in, people learn by what they see you do. So you're teaching some things, and based upon how you operate in this life, people believe that what you're doing is the right thing, and you operate in ignorance of who you really are, and you can lead a whole lot of people astray. So the knowledge that we're talking about is, first of all, knowing your God, knowing your purpose, and then you are in the position to guide someone else into that area that they can be delivered from destruction.
What Mother Crawford said to you, Pastor Marcella? What you remember her, what she said?
Yes.
Every morning, every day, she had this group of her students repeating. Repeat it for us, please.
What is knowledge? That's the question she would have asked. And we had to respond. Knowledge is power. And this became part of our soul.
And what is ignorance?
Is ignorance? And all of us have to say, it is the most disgraceful thing on the face of the earth.
I get the impression that sometimes we find pleasure more in ignorance than in knowledge, because we create an environment and glorify, you know. I'm ignorant, brother. Don't try me, I'm ignorant. As if ignorance is a university degree.
I like what Pastor Hudson said. And, you know, I re-examine my own life constantly. I successfully failed common entrance, what we commonly call the SSCE, secondary school entrance examination. Mm-hmm. Successfully failed it twice. But I recognize, through the constant banging from my parents and loved ones, about the consequences, the serious and dire consequences of ignorance.
Yeah, yeah.
So it forced me to seek knowledge and to recognize that even though I might have had a late start, while others were moving ahead, you know, with the help and the grace of God, there is always the possibility that I can become better.
And I like what you said about the Word of God, because it is in the Word of God that I believe knowledge begins with an understanding of God. Mm-hmm. Because it is out of the Word of God you discover yourself, and as you discover yourself, you discover that you are valuable and useful. You know, this same building we're doing this program, Generation Next, I never forget how several years ago Pastor Messiah, our senior pastor, was concerned about young men. He said, you know, the girls seem to be taking off, but then the brothers don't seem to quite understand. And many of them are grown. They are now becoming middle-aged men, grown men. We would like them to rediscover themselves. And so he said, let us set up a remedial program, strictly for men, to teach them. Pastor Lee, I thought some of them, when you look at them, they left school since at primary, dropped out of primary school, didn't even write the, what you call the common entrance. But yet still, because of who they are in Christ, and their increasing knowledge of not just God, but who they are in Him, these brothers went down to write the CXE and the GC examination and passed it some with distinction.
Amen.
Did mathematics. They claimed hard, so hard, and passed it with grade ones and grade twos. Which means that once you and I get a greater understanding, a greater knowledge of God, God will help us with all the other knowledge we need.
You know, even in your relationship with your wife, the Word of God talks about treating your wife according to knowledge. And you know, sometimes, you know, I didn't know that before, you know. I didn't know that before.
So
I just had a wife, and I knew that I had a wife. And I treated my wife how I thought a wife should be treated. You know, but the Bible says according to knowledge. How important it is reading the Word of God and gaining knowledge, knowing how to treat your spouse, knowing how to resolve differences in your marriages. You know, it's so important. That's why we have people who they have this influx of domestic violence taking place, because men see their wives as slaves. Men see their wives as just another person in the house. And so I've learned through the Word of God, because the Word of God has an answer for every single thing. Yeah. It begins there. You know God, and when you begin to have a relationship with God, He now teaches you through the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And so it is important that you expose yourself to these truths consistently, mm-hmm. not one day, every single day, reading the Word of God and getting an idea. How could I resolve these issues? How must I treat my wife? The Bible says, love your wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself.
So, you know, we cannot hold property in man. And I like that, because this whole thing about, and Pastor, you made mention of the inability to reason. I think that kept coming out from you all the time, even before we started this program. And this whole thing about the inability to reason, and you touching domestic violence, and you know, you see women appear with a black eye and a swelled face and a broken leg and so on. That's a dark side, you know.
Yeah.
You know, I can remember Professor Dance said to us that, and let us not believe that this side is only prevalent in those women in some poor socioeconomic communities that will run up the road and all, oh God, Morty beating me and so on. You know, Professor Dan said that in some sophisticated environment, they will not sponge around the broom. and so when the lashes fire, you know, there is no bursting or tearing of the skin, but the wounds are there. And he says sometimes if you jam these women, you know, the wound is there. And the thing is, that's a dark side.
Yeah.
And you only beat people when you believe they are your property.
Yeah. But
with knowledge, you understand that horses are not slave. Man cannot hold property in man, and therefore you treat people as human beings. So that's a good way to resolve those conflicts. The word of God, knowledge.
Yeah.
A man by the name of Stephen Covey, one of very popular modern popular management writers, wrote a book on 7 habits of successful people. One of the habits he identified was, he said, out of the international research himself and the university scholars would have done, they found that in every successful person, there were 7 fundamental traits or habits, meaning that they did over and over again, that was a part or responsible for their success. And one of them he identified was, seek to understand, then to be understood. And when I heard my brother speaking about the word of God saying, husbands, treat your wife according to knowledge, it reminded me of that principle of seeking to understand before you attempt to be understood. Because lots of time we jump to conclusions, lots of time we don't have a clue what we're dealing with, and instead of seeking to understand, we already want people to understand us. Now, I don't know of no relationship that can exist, survive in ignorance. If you do not seek to understand the people, no work in the office is going to be done. You're going to always consistently have a hostile environment. If you do not seek to understand your spouse, you will consistently have a hostile environment. And what is going to happen once you consistently create a hostile environment? The dark side obviously is going to come up. Nasty things are going to happen simply because no one stopped to understand and then to be understood.
And it's the demonstration of love. Love causes us to just humble ourselves and not be selfish or operate in a way where we have always the upper hand. You need to understand that with knowledge of God, there is a particular phrase, verse of scripture, declaration by Jesus. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens. Without the strength of Christ, without the knowledge of knowing Christ, everything that you try can be disastrous.
You know, as you were speaking there, I was thinking, because when we look in society today and we see the amount of harm that people are perpetrating against each other, you know, because of lack of knowledge, and people declaring over themselves how ignorant they are, and, you know, I think of self-preservation. And how we can preserve ourselves in Christ, you know, with knowledge, knowing what is harmful and what is beneficial to our well-being, you know, and the well-being of others. Because what I love with scripture, the scripture, it mentions that we are to do unto others as we will have them do unto us. So when we embrace knowledge and we understand that we are all made in the image and in the likeness of God, we will know how to treat with each other. And the same measure we measure out others will be measured out to us. So if I look out for your well-being, I have the assurance it might not be you, but it might be the other person who might be looking after my well-being. And if we should embrace that attitude with the knowledge we have, with the faith we have in the Lord Jesus Christ, with the power of the Holy Spirit working in us, the blood of the Lord, and the Word of God, I think we are on the road to great recovery.
Yeah, I had a few friends who we used to be together, and they would use the same term, Pasano, that you say, I'm an ignorant person. And if they get in a story, I would go and say, man, no, behave yourself. Don't worry with this fighting thing.
No, but Emily, even besides being ignorant, some say, me mouth hot. Me mouth hot.
But everybody's the Pasano. When I talk to you, and you still want, go forward and do your stupid. I run away. Yeah, because I frightened the police. So I just leave you right here. I got.
Hear what Peter said. His divine power has given us everything we need for godly life through our knowledge of Him who called us by His own glory and goodness. Through these, He has given us His very great and precious promises, so that through them we may participate in the divine nature, having escaped the corruption in the world caused by evil desires. So evil desires are there. So what are we actually saying is that knowledge provides a filter. Here Peter says, for this very reason, make every effort, because there's this, the evil desires there, these different things that will try to press us, pull us in one direction or the other, to bring out that dark side inside of us. For this very reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness. Try to be moral. Add to your faith through the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, through the power of the Holy Spirit, and through the Word of God. Yeah. And to goodness, therefore, add knowledge. So knowledge is very critical, because I find that it helps us to filter our action, filter our judgments, our decision making. You know, recently Pan-American Health Organization started to speak about the amount of deaths that are being caused by that affect men. They claim that men are now dying more than women. And they thought that it has to do with the decisions that men are making. And so they said, men are dying from infections, from accidents, from assaults, from suicide, and from cardiovascular conditions, simply because of lack of knowledge and not applying that knowledge to themselves. And therefore, if you and I gain knowledge, we speak from a spiritual position, they're speaking from a secular position, but they're actually saying, you need some understanding, you need a filter, you need to develop a filter.
I want to underscore biblical knowledge as the most critical of all the knowledge that you would receive. What we need to do, because there are lots of things out there to be learned, real evil things as well. I mean, knowledge is on the increase. It's a characteristic of the last day in any case. So the knowledge of the Word acts as a filter to every other knowledge that will come your way, because there are things that you could stumble upon that could aid and abet the dark side that we're trying to run away from. So critical is the knowledge of the Word. And here's Psalm 119, verse 104 and 105. Hear what it says. It says, through thy precepts I get understanding, therefore I hate every false way. This is exactly what I'm talking about. As the light and the entrance of the Word comes in, it would repel every strategic piece of information that is out there that is contrary to the Word of God, contrary to what God wants for you. And here, verse 105, it says, thy Word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Why not allow the Word of God to
you know,
be that source?
We have a life that is referred to as the inner life. And if we deal with the inner life, well, then the outer will be manifested in the way God would have wanted us to operate. Most people spend time fixing the outside. And
not fixing the inside. And this is where knowledge is important, because knowledge helps in terms of formation of character, godly character, that is critical for the success of any human being and dealing with the dark side. And so we have to spend time understanding the Word of God. And when we do that, we develop things like honesty and patience and tolerance and integrity, you know, wholeness of heart. And so knowledge, we cannot escape knowledge. And that's why Hosea was clear. People are destroyed if you don't understand or you don't study my precepts. God says, I will forget not only you, but your children also.
Yeah, yeah.
And so knowledge is important, critical.
And when you have knowledge, it brings you to a place where you start to respect those that are around you, because you now know how to protect others from being destroyed.
It also shapes your mind. The Bible said, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So knowledge is so important, shapes the way you think. As you read the Word of God, spiritual knowledge, it helps you.
Even before you gain knowledge, you have to be disciplined. Mm-hmm. When you're disciplined, then you will gain knowledge.
Knowledge increases your self-control. We'll talk more about that next week. Knowledge increases your perseverance. If you want to succeed in this life, I agree with Peter. Along with your faith, along with your moral goodness, you need a filter. You need knowledge. I recommend the knowledge of the Word of God first, because that's foundational.
Yeah.
It assists you with being able to filter all the other knowledge you will have. And I pray that you will increase your academic pursuits, not just being religious and being an understanding the Word of God, but develop yourself, develop your skill. I don't care how long you would have left school. I don't care when you drop out or who say you're done. Forget that. Start developing. There are several programs around here. Even at Generation X, where we are, there are programs here. And no matter how old you are or how young you are, God has a plan and a purpose for you. Develop it. God bless you.
We thank you for being part of Choices. Remember, you can join us at First Assembly for any of our regular weekly services. I'm Salisha, on behalf of the set, reminding you that your whole life is the sum of your choices. God bless you.